And again, we compute the difference here, which is 46,250 minus 40,000, or 6,250 over 40,000. And of course, we have to multiply by 100 to make it a percent. And we get an answer of 15.6, or I'll just call it 16% error. Now, 16% seems like a lot. This experiment, like every experiment ever done in physics, is subject to error. Now, the tricky thing is identifying and quantifying the sources of our error. Now, in this situation, we're really lucky. We have a known reference number to compare to. We know the Earth has a circumference of 40,000 kilometers. So when we make some calculations and get an answer that's different, we can immediately quantify how wrong we were. But when Eratosthenes was doing this experiment, he didn't know that. He had no idea what the actual circumference was, and so it would have been to his benefit to keep track of error as he was going along. So let's do that for this experiment.